I would think, I mean, what comes to mind is ability to make choices and decide things for yourself and feel totally in control of situation. There are several, but what comes to mind is the underlying discrimination in every dimension of life which a woman faces, be it family, be it outside the family, government programs, policies, general attitude. I mean, many a times it's visible, many a times it's very subtle, but it's there, the discrimination, and it is a pattern too. We see a pattern. I mean, you know, like if you look at the policies, so policies are not gender specific. I mean, you can see that policies are mostly formed keeping in mind issues which are general, and when we say general, it's men's issues. So for women issues to be addressed, you need to have very, very specific understanding of the problems and accordingly to have solutions within the policy framework. But for example, health. So we have a lot of health intervention in India, I mean health policies, health intervention, but women is not taken as a category in that health discourse. So what happens that, you know, like you would look at in general tuberculosis, in general heart issues, in general eradication of several things, but when you look at a woman biologically also, and also if you factor in the social and economical issues, you would always find that when it comes to a woman, health issues are aggravated for her. Similarly, for quite some time now there's some change, but you know, in the field of education, I mean, we found in India there's so many women who are dropping out after primary level, and one of the reasons was that the women, girl child, did not have access to toilets. She did not have, I mean, many girls children, they dropped out because they were not having the facility of sanitary napkins, easily available sanitary napkins in the villages, and as a result, after attaining puberty, they would not be going to school. So in any sector, I mean, if you look at policy, policy is nothing but every sector would have some policy in a developing world, I mean, which is designed for everyone. But when you look at the sectors, you would realize that women is never taken as a category, I mean, the special consideration that she would need. So what happens, since the entire world is still going very masculine, so those concerns are kind of hidden, they're not brought up in the general discourse before the policy is formulated, and also in implementation. I mean, shifting from policy to implementation, you would see that the program implementation is such that it excludes women. This can be deliberate also, and not so deliberate also, but the way things are designed, and women from their side, they take things for granted. I mean, they feel okay, I mean, all the sub-centers, for example, I mean, it's meant for, I mean, exclusively meant for women and child health, but the access is very poor of those facilities which they have. Similarly, the public distribution system, education system, the way development resources in the villages, like for example, MGNREGA program. So the way resources are used, utilized in the villages. So, I mean, when we make the plan, we never think that, okay, I mean, we have limited resource. So should we also not consider the need and requirement of a woman? I mean, what does she need? She needs accessibility of good drinking water. I mean, she would be needing accessibility to fodder, maybe, to have a safe environment. So all those things are not really taken in a very, very specific manner. And I personally feel that when we say that it's for all, it's not for all. I mean, when we say it's for all, actually it, then, you know, like whoever has more power, whoever is more vocal, whoever is more articulate, gets everything. For example, in India, when we see that the Panchayati Raj institutions, I mean, in fact, they have 50% reservation now in the PRI sector, and women are also coming to the forefront. But last several years' data, if you really look at them, their contribution also has not been, I mean, not noteworthy, I would think. I mean, the idea was or thought was that when women are coming in leadership roles in these villages, they would be better off and probably their plan would reflect concern for women. But since women chosen leaders are also so stereotyped, you know, like it's kind of internalizing everything. I mean, she has the same value set which a man would have. I mean, she feels that if she'll make a better mukhya, if she perpetuates whatever is going on. So that that definitely makes a lot of difference to women's empowerment overall. As a term, I mean, it's a very feminine connotation. I mean, that word comes to my mind that whenever we think of Shakti is something feminine. I mean, we never think that it's something masculine. So that decides that Shakti is a feminine issue. And also a lot of feminist agenda can be rallied around the word Shakti. And what also comes to mind is that it's a very powerful symbol, because Shakti is something which is understood by all. Understood by all, meaning right from village to town to man to woman, everybody understand that when we have this term Shakti, we are referring to something which is a feminine concept.